Stockinette or stocking stitch is just alternating rows of knit stitches and purl stitches. When knit as a flat piece of work, it will curl. So if you're knitting something like a gauge swatch, start and end with a couple of rows of garter stitch and do a couple of knit stitches at the start and end of each row. This will stop it from curling as much and will make a gauge swatch easier to measure because once you've blocked it, it should lay pretty much flat. So here I have my cast on stitches and I'm going to start with a row of knit stitches. If you need some guidance on how to do a knit stitch, I have a separate tutorial which will show you how to do that. I'm then going to turn my work and do a row of purl stitches. Once I've done a couple of rows, you can see how the stitch is looking. On the back, it does look different to the front. This is the back, and if I turn it around, this is the right side of my work, and you can see that it appears in these columns of V's. I've now done four rows, and you can really see how the stitch is looking. If you forget whether you should be doing knit stitches or purl stitches, if you're at the front of the work, where you can see these columns of V's, you should be doing knit stitches. Whereas if you're on the back of the work, you should be doing purl stitches. I've knit a larger swatch of stockinette stitch to show you how it looks and to show you the curling I was describing. So if I sort of let this fall by itself, it will try to curl like this. And if I try and straighten it out, it won't ever really straighten up, it just keeps trying to curl. Another thing to bear in mind is that if you're knitting in the round, you're knitting in a spiral, so you'll end up knitting stockinette stitch if you just knit every round with no purling.